Wow, wasn't that epic? Welcome back to the Journeyman Project 3. Now if I remember correctly, I think we're in the time thing. Now I think I've corrected the other issues that we've been having. The sound stuttering and me sounding like I'm 5 miles away. So let's hope that that's all okay. Let's see what our friend Arthur has to say.
Well, here we go, Gage. We need to find the 3 pieces of the Sosequi legacy. The time coordinates are in your menu. Choose one and we'll be on our way.
So wait, we've got 3 now, so these are, what, did you say exactly 1 day beforehand? So this is 1 day before the universe explodes for all 3 of them, so 1262, okay, hang on, what?
Meanwhile, back at the Batcave.
Gage, tell me honestly. You're really the only guy that works here, right?
Oh, yeah, I think he is. I agree. I do agree with him, though. I mean, if you've ever played the other Journeyman projects, you'll understand why he said that. Basically, because he always ends up doing all of them, to be honest. But hey, you know, somebody's got to save the world, and someone's got to be the protagonist, so... Okay, let's pick one of these wonderful things, and let's get kicking off. Get sucked into the toilet again. See, this looks much better than when we saw it before. Whoop! Fantastic. Alright.
Look to the center of the city. That's the intact temple that the Sirolans obliterated into flaky temple dandruff.
Flaky
the
temple
layout
dandruff.
Of the city seems to radiate around it as if it dominated every aspect of their culture. Sounds like a good place to start.
Well, that's as good a place as any, my friend, so... See if I can spin myself out again. Let's have a look around.
What an incredible city. Quite a difference from the aquarium we saw on our last visit.
Well, quite.
Judging from the caldera crescent shape of this island, I would gather that it was once an active volcano. If Agent 3 was right, and this really was Atlantis, then it surpassed even the most fantastic legends of its existence.
Well, this is going to get trippy, because we have been here before, but it didn't quite look the same. Whoa! Ooh, these look interesting. Let's take some of these. I'm sorry, Arthur. Do you want me to put them back? I can put them back. Let's go over here.
We have a lot of ground to cover, so if you get stuck, we can always time jump to another environment.
Mm-hmm.
Don't fret. I'll log the precise coordinates, so when you choose to return, we'll appear exactly on the spot where we left.
That's extremely handy.
Gage, those gears look like they belong with the pegs in the floor.
No, really? Ooh, okay. Look, you're starting to get a bit too handy, in my opinion. Can we get handheld a little? Maybe I should just ignore him for a little bit.
Igor, pull the first lever.
You know what? I'm only going to click on these, because these are way more fun than these little light bulbs.
I need a lever that won't drive me crazy.
But owing to his hint, I think he is right then. Question is, why are we doing this?
A few more turns, Gage.
Heave!
Put your back into it, laddie.
Oh, yeah, it's easy for you to say, you virtual fool. Sitting in my helmet doing bugger all. Oh, come on, how many times do we have to pull this? What's the point of it? Is it? Is this even doing anything? You know what? One more time, and then I reckon we'll give him a crunch. Hang on, was that one different? It looked different.
There's the broken windmill spar. Now that we have it aligned, we should be able to walk out onto it.
Really? Can we? Oh, wow, we can. The question is, how dangerous is this? Can I walk any further? No, apparently not. Oh, jeez, that was a bit... I thought it was a face. We can't walk that way. Can't walk... this way? Alright, maybe we just pull the lever again? Whoa! Oh wow, bananas. We go for a swim now?
The first description of Atlantis in literature was from Plato in a series of discussions from his works Timaeus and Critias. According to Plato, Atlantis was a utopia that existed somewhere in the Western Ocean. It was never known whether Plato was actually describing the fabled lost continent or fabricating an elaborate concept to help prove an argument, as he was known to do.
Probably. We could go down there.
There's not much action up here. My friends would faint if they heard me say this, but let's get down to those docks. I feel so cheap.
Oh, dear.
We shouldn't stand here for too long. From up here, we're likely to be seen.
More than likely.
Hi down there! Who, us? Just a couple of windmill repairmen doing their job. Gage, quick, show them your butt crack.
What?
Anyway, we should find a guy's quickly before we really are spotted.
Oh yeah, that's right. We need to change our appearance. We need to go incognitis. Oh, there's a nice view up here. Can we... Well, now what? Hang on.
The writings on the sail on the back of that docked boat tell me it's Egyptian. Let's see, it reads, "My other ship is a barge?"
Can we... Oh, crap. Alright, let's leap from one to the other. That's a safe option, eh? Okay. This isn't by coincidence. As if you wouldn't be noticed. I mean, really, if there was somebody over there, as if we wouldn't be noticed doing this in a chameleon suit. Yes, Arthur.
Remember, don't look down. I told you not to look down. Now you better use the umbrella.
We had one, and this was Super Mario, and I was Peach. Yes, that would work really well. Sadly, I am not.
Avast, ye landlubbers. Ye face Arthur the Terrible and Blackwood the mildly terrible but still racist mom. Strike ye colors and prepare to be naughty.
Don't mind me, I'm feeling particularly naughty today.
What was that?
Sorry, Gage, but you can't go any further. There's a native just out of sight ahead. You're going to have to assume a chameleon guise before you can go that way.
Oh, really? What's over here, then? Water. Great. We can't swim. Hey. Ooh, hang on. What? Why can't I go see this guy? Oh, he's blind! Well, that would help. Can we talk to him?
A few coins for a blind old beggar.
I don't think I have any.
Sorry, I can't help you.
Looks like nasty weather.
Nasty weather? That's strange. Even a cautious weatherman would tell you that today is a parasailing day.
No.
I'm sorry, I would have to disagree.
Really? I could have sworn I felt a star moving in. Well then, in that case, I think I'll stay here and get some rest.
Good for you. Sitting there, blind, in your corner. We can't say much more to him, I guess. But this means we do have a nice little guise we can wear. Look, I'm a blind man, walking around without assistance. That's not obvious at all, is it? Now, hang on. He said there was a... Whoops. Hang on. What?
I'm fairly certain that the dock ship is of Egyptian make. What would it be doing here, so far from home?
Hang on. What? Ooh. It's this. Pole. What am I going to do with that?
Captain's log, star day 1262 BC. On a routine expedition, we've stumbled upon a strange Atlantean vessel with no crew. I'm hoping to rescue a naive alien mermaid shackled within the brig of this ship.
Just stop, you fool. Really? I mean, he's entertaining, but... Yeah, hang on. Oh, I can steal him too. This is interesting. Now we got a couple of dudes.
Yes.
Nice hair. Oh, a few coins.
A few coins for a blind old beggar.
Oh, right. Right, coins.
Well, oh, cool.
Is there not something you wish to say?
No thanks. Why? Oh!
Oh, yes, of course. Where are my manners? Thank you, friend.
No, that's not... That is to say... There you are not whom I was expecting.
Ah, okay.
I must go now.
Very well, then.
Fair enough.
He's a cagey fellow, but I guess being locked up will do
that. Yeah.
Still, he seems to be waiting for someone in particular. Hmm.
Wait, why am I talking to you like you're a real person? I'm supposed to talk to myself like I'm a real person. Let's go this way. We got some what do we got? We got some coins. This is a daff. Reach of nearly 10 feet! I don't know how you measure it. Excuse me. Geez, sorry everyone. Nearly 10 feet? It's quite interesting. What's that? Where's that coming from? Ooh. And yet another man to steal.
It almost looks like he's waiting for a passenger. The guy is some sort of ferryman.
Maybe.
If so, he must know the lay of the land. A boat would take us pretty far in this one seahorse town. Maybe we should ask him to take us somewhere.
Well, yes, but the question is where, Arthur? Where on earth? Whoa! No! Okay. I've learned to do it. I've learned to manipulate it. Look at this, ladies and gentlemen. Just little clicks. Baby steps, baby steps. And yet... There we go. Now we're okay. I mean, I apologize if it's making anyone sick. Let's have a chat to him.
No, not this time. Look, I have to make a living too, you know. Try your luck with someone else.
There are no other ferrymen at this dock.
Well then, I guess you'll just have to wait for one.
Oh, come on, man.
No, I told you, I'm out of the charity business.
Yeah, but we got coins now.
I'll pay back what I owe you.
Oh, pay back what you owe. I guess the wine and song of the festival has loosened pockets as well as tongues. Look, do yourself a favor, huh? Keep your money and take another ferry.
Really? Okay, so that's not working too well. Hang on. Well, we're dressed as a beggar, aren't we? I don't think it allows us to change when we're in view. We can't walk up to him as a self and not like that and not like him, so... Let's give this guy a crack. I mean... No, actually give him a... Ugh, that's not good. I don't want to do that either. Take me somewhere.
Oh... Where can I
That's
take you?
That's a bit
you?
Creepy. Anyone else finding that guy creepy? Windmill? Well, we're at the windmill now. Let's go to temple?
The temple.
I guess for this...
That will be ten
what? Tendramoy. Jeez, he's happy about something, isn't he? Almost creepily happy. Not too creepy. Whoopsie.
Sorry. I am Kashani, but everyone calls me Kasha. You must be the captain of the boat they captured just this morning. I know how you feel. I am a victim too. The Atlanteans captured anyone that passes by. Now the Atlanteans have kept their city secret for over 1,000 years. Whenever a ship passes too close, they capture it and they force the crew to live here as second-class citizens. No one is allowed to leave. The rules are very strict.
Really? Okay.
Okay, this is it. Have a good day now.
I will. Thank you so much, sir. Ah, nice cow. This way, perhaps? Everything is water. It's like Venice up in here. Steal this guy. Can we talk to him? Hello, sir, with funny hair.
No second-class citizens in the temple.
Why?
Gage, you like movies about gladiators?
that I do, my friend. Well, yeah, why not?
So, why aren't second-class citizens allowed in?
By decree of the Templars.
What do you mean? Well, who's the Templars?
Who is allowed into the temple?
Only native Atlantean citizens making deliveries or possessing a gold temple medallion may enter.
Okay. Well, who makes deliveries?
What kind of things get delivered to the temple?
Anything the Templars have need of.
Chickens? Pizza?
Today, deliveries are expected from the olive oil and potter shops.
Oh, really? Tell me about this temple medallion, dear sir.
What medallion?
A gold medallion bearing the seal of the temple. How do you expect to gain entry without one?
Dumb luck, I guess. What you got to say?
This guard is protecting a lock. Sort of a water elevator for boats, so they can get from one level of the canals to the next. It looks like we need to use this one to get up to the reservoir around the temple.
Yeah. And it's not helping either.
Maybe we could go to the olive oil shop and see what kind of deliveries are going into the temple. There might be something there that could help us get by the guard.
That was my thinking, sir.
Well, then it would seem that I'm not going to the temple.
Good day.
Have a good day, sir. And a happy evening, maybe. Jeez. Okay.
He barred you from entering because you were a second-class citizen. Sounds like the city has set up some sort of rigid caste system. Maybe you could imitate the guise of another person a few rungs higher on the social ladder and find a way around the lock guard.
We have to find someone first.
Oh, so, where are we off to this time?
That cheesy grin down on Cheesy Palace. Sorry, his face is just getting cheesy. Oil vendor?
The olive oil vendor's shop.
How did I know he was going to say that? Because it seems to be the flat rate around here. Oh well, at least you get stuck in traffic. You know it's only going to cost you 10 demoi. Yes, yes, let's go.
Do not lose hope, huh? You are not alone. Many of the non-natives refuse to live as captives. They have formed an underground resistance group and are planning to escape the island. Last I heard, they were almost ready. They will probably contact you soon, if they have not already. Hey, do not tell anyone what I have told you.
What do you How do you know I'm not the authorities? Why would you just tell someone that? Oh well. Let's see. Where are we now?
All right. We've arrived. Thank you for your business, eh?
Are you facing the What are you doing? That's just... Anyway. Okay. Off we go. Pots, 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 pots. Lots of... Well, okay. Forward, then? Whoa. Big dude.
That's Mr. Atlantean, 1281 BC. Still looking good, champ. My, my. He has a big... pot. This must be the craftsman responsible for all those monstrous pithoi around
what?
The city.
Oh, the... For those playing the home game, this thing here is a pithoi.
The shop is for paying customers only.
Huh? Hey!
Please, I am not the only potter in town. Maybe someone else can help you.
Yeah. Okay, we won't talk to us who we are. Oh, I know. Let's use the guard. Maybe he'll talk to me. Me, as in him, as in me. Looking like him? That's gonna hurt my head after a while. Okay. Oop, back this way. Let's have a chat now, son.
I'm sorry. I am much too busy for customers today. Perhaps if it is not a problem, you could come back in a couple of days?
No, I... Why are you busy?
Why are you so busy?
Oh, I have yet a dozen pots to fire before the Kalas Kalire celebration. Oh, it is unfair. Oh, the festival is finally here, and I am missing it because I have to make the wine amphorae.
Okay, what? Kalas Kalire?
Kalos Kalire?
The final day of the festival? The great battle? Honestly, I am much too busy. Maybe you should come back in a couple of days.
No. What's in the kiln?
What's in the kiln?
My pots. If I do not watch them carefully, they could crack. And if that happens, I will never make it to the festival. Oh, if only my sister would finish making the olive oil.
Oh?
You have a sister?
Yes, she makes olive oil. Her shop is next door.
Well, he said that. Okay.
It looks like you've got a lot to do. I'll just be on my way.
Things will be back to normal in 2 days, I promise.
Sounds Russian all of a sudden. Ooh, what's this?
Normally, Gage, I would tell you not to touch anything while you're in a store. But you're older now. Go ahead.
Oh, yes, play with please. The machine.
Yes, Mike, it's Amazing Discoveries, and this week we're showing you the amazing Play-Doh Pasta Press. It twists, it squeezes. Order now and you can make a spinach pasta, an artichoke pasta, or how about an Iceland terracotta?
Oh, no. Oh, he's fantastic. I love him. What is, whoa. Hold on. Wait a second. That's not good. Maybe we just move away for a second. That's it. Oh, he is a riot. I like this guy already. We probably can't touch anything while we're in here. While he's in here. Let's go see his sister. Because everyone wants to. Well, she just seemed to be in high demand. I mean, she is the one... olive oil business. Next door? Is this next door? I mean, this is the only other place we can go, I guess.
Well, that's olive oil.
Those are black olives basking in the sun. Mediterranean cultures like the Minoans were able to cultivate the rocky fields to grow olive trees, creating a lucrative olive oil trade. From the amount here, I'd say that olives were one of the chief exports of Atlantis.
What is that? Oh, it's her. Steal your guys and then talk to you.
Well, good morning. I'm surprised to see an Atlantean who is not at the festival. Well, my brother and I aren't, only because we have too much work to do before the Kalos Kalir celebration tomorrow.
Well, this is fair. Brother, well, we already know.
Might I know your brother?
Perhaps. He is Telos, the potter, next door. I must warn you, he is grumpy because he has too much work to go to the festival. I think sometimes he forgets that sacrifice is the purest form of homage.
I agree.
So why is everyone making such a fuss about the Kalos Kalire?
Ooh, sorry.
Shame on you. You were born here. You know its significance.
Ooh, jeez. All right, just... All right, don't tell me about it. Unless we talk to... we could talk to her as someone who doesn't know. Well, then she probably wouldn't jeer at us so much. Why are you so busy?
I'm busy, eh? What could be so important that it can't be put off?
I have got to fill all these amphorae before the celebration, and then we must deliver them. It takes two of us to lift one. But, of course, it is only a small measure of my devotion. The Earth Mother's blessings can never be repaid.
What? Where are you delivering them to?
Some will go to residences and some will go to the temple, but most we will bring to the Colosseum. If you look closely, you will see they are stamped with the seals of their owners, so we know where to deliver them to.
Well, I should leave you to your work.
Earth Mother's blessings.
Handy. Seals, eh? Well, I am dressed as the guy who told us to get a seal. Can we look at them? Whoops. Not down there. Can we... Oh, we can look at this one. What's this one? Yes.
The double axe was the holiest symbol to the Minoans. Religious axes were used by priests to kill sacrificial bulls for their beloved earth goddess.
We can't take it. What can we do with it? Is it a scarf? I can't remember. Scarf. Asian stuff. Stick. Well, this is... What was this? Clay. Clay. Well, maybe we can steal it like you do with keys. I mean, I don't know how to do that. Did it work? Oh, cool. It has a seal on it.
Now the guard is looking for a gold medallion. Our next project for Arts and Crafts Day, kids, will be to make our fake medallion look gold. I haven't seen any gold around here. We might have to look elsewhere, maybe even another time zone.
Well, hang on. What's one of the places, El Dorado? Well, the Andes Mountains. Alright. Well, since we're reaching our little 25-minute time limit, which I try to keep on these videos, because people will get... Whoops.
Atlantis was more of a copper than a gold. But El Dorado, heck, they called it the lost city of gold. Sounds like a great place
Thanks,
to pan
Arthur,
for gold
I
to me.
I figured that out. So I think what we'll do is let's transport to El Dorado to get some gold. Andes? Is it the Andes? Yes, it's the Andes. Here we go. Yes! Whee! Palm trees. Oh, at least we're not in a well this time. Alright, we'll leave it here and I'll see you next time.